I'm going to show you around the Dufour 36 performance from 2012. This yacht design won the European Yacht of the Year award in 2013 for the Cruiser Racer class. It has a deep fin keel with a large T-bowl, optimal sailing performance. As we move aft, you'll see the sail drive with a two-bladed folding bronze propeller, the minimal drag and maximum control whilst under engine. She has a large single rudder, giving control and stability with a neutral helm control feel whilst under sail. Moving aft, we'll see the wide stern, chimed hull and folding swim platform. The cockpit layout is open and spacious, with a wheel on each side for optimum visibility while sailing. The main sheet is mounted on the cockpit floor, and she has throttle and autopilot controls on the starboard side. Moving forward, we'll see the Harkin setup on this boat with winches for the main sheet, jib and halyards, and all the lines led aft to the Harkin clutches. Towards the stern of the boat, we'll see plenty of stowage under the cockpit flooring and also under the side seating for warps, fenders and a life raft. Moving forward, we'll see there's a framework for a spray hood as an option on this boat, being a cruiser racer. She has a low profile coach roof design with the jib cars set close to that for easy walkway. This boat has both laminate sails for cruising and option for a carbon racing suite as well, available within the full asking price. The open foredeck design is a clean one throughout, with a retractable pole on the starboard side, a large anchor well, and furling head sail system. Her sail inventory is very strong, with both racing and cruising sails, but may open her up as a boat for anyone. Now we will go down below to have a look at the interior design. This boat can seat 6 persons in 2 cabins and the saloon, with a galley mounted to port, L-shaped. She has a twin hob, oven and grill, a 12-volt deep refrigerator, top loading, and twin stainless steel sinks with a hot and cold mixer tap. Nav station mounted to the starboard side, with all the controls for the electrical systems and nav aids. As we move forward into the saloon, we'll see the single settees on both port and starboard, central table, and double doors to the forward cabin, which is a very lovely feature on this design. This makes her a comfortable boat to sleep on, and also for racing, dropping spinnakers into the forward cabin. Moving aft, we'll see on the starboard side, the heads mounted with a Jabsco manual toilet and a molded single seat with a pull-out tap to double up as a shower, and a master suite on the port side. Thank you for looking at this boat. Full details available at www.whyboats.com.